beauties, and welcome to another Will I Buy It? New makeup releases, drugstore, indie, am I interested or not? Is it going on the wish list? Well, you know how it works. And if you do not, first off, welcome. This concept was not created by me. It was created by Samantha March. Instead of an anti-haul, she decided to do a Will I Buy It and give a more positive spin on, well, new makeup releases. And I think that is a fantastic idea. I will leave her channel down or her playlist of her own Will I Buy It videos down below in my description box. She was also so sweet to create a community playlist where creators such as myself can add their videos to. I will leave that one underneath as well and up in the cards if I don't forget. Another household message. I am part of a fantastic, well, small group of tiny YouTubers called the Beauty YouTubers Growth Group. I have listed all their channels down below in my description box. I also created a community playlist where I just add, or actually it's a group playlist where I add their videos too. So it is not community wise, it is just on my own channel. And yeah, so you can check out a few of, well, the videos. I will leave that underneath the card if I don't forget. But it is also listed in my description box. All the sources that I use on Instagram are also down below. The products I am going to talk about today are also down below. The look that I have now, I have filmed. I think I talked in, it was a few Will I Buy It ago that I said that Revolution came out with some holiday boxes and I was probably not going to get anything. Don't judge. I got this one. I saw it in stores and yeah, it normally retails for 35 euros, something around those lines, and I got it for 25. So I thought I need it. And yeah. So that is the look that I have. I have filmed it. I have filmed this look. And what is exactly in the box, that will be up maybe this week, but I'm not sure. Otherwise, it will be up next week. And just a question, actually. This chocolate heart contains two eyeshadow palettes, a face palette and a bronzer. Do you guys want me to do a full review? Because I can do that. I can, because the palettes are a little bit bigger, they are chocolate bar palettes, I can do three looks with each of the two eyeshadow palettes and maybe a separate look in the review with just the face palette or something like that. Let me know down in the description box if that is of interest to you. I am a color lover, hence this eye makeup. I do like neutral looks as well, I just don't do them that often. If you want me to do a neutral look, leave it down in the comment section below and I will be happy to oblige. Everything I say today is my own opinion and I am not saying that you should or should not buy something. It is just why I will or won't or that kind of stuff. So everything out of the way. Let me go to the side a little bit and make sure I do not fall off the screen, okay? Let me turn my mirror because I have my tablet propped up on my mirror, so I don't have to hold it. But yeah, let's just get into it and let's start with drugstore. I always start with drugstore and let's start with Essence. I saw this. It was just a cute, well, eyeshadow palette, and at first I thought it was a picture. I don't know if you know that, but we have a candy here that are in heart forms and then you have a text on top like I love you or heart or kisses or something like that, and they're very, very cute, and this really reminds me of it. So I thought it was cute, and when I looked at the shadows I was like, oh well, if they are very light, but I think that you can create some nice, well, maybe pastel-y looks with it or something like that. So I went into the comment section and of course Essence. This is only releasing in the USA. Essence is actually a European brand, as is Catrice. They are both from Germany. They are sister brands, but they just release stuff in Europe and they release stuff in the US. And it is not the same stuff. It is different stuff. And that just really pisses me off. I do wanted to mention this because I think it is just a cute little eyeshadow palette. If you see it in stores and you grab it, let me know down below how this works, because I am actually quite sad that we cannot get that here. Because if I look at the swatches, not that swatches give you the whole story, but I kind of like the colors. But yeah, I cannot get it here. Moving on to the next thing that Essence is coming out with, which is probably releasing in Europe. That is what I just meant, but this is a Stay Cool Llama highlighter, and I just thought it was fun. I just thought it was fun. It has a rosé shine. Don't really know what they mean by that. Probably that it is a pinkish highlighter, I think. But yeah, I think it's kind of fun. If I see it in stores, maybe I will swatch it. And if I like it, maybe I will pick it up. The Essence highlighter, the nude highlighter that everyone is raving about, I cannot get here. It's only sold in the US. So maybe I can check this one out. I don't know. If I see it, I will swatch it. If I like it, I will pick it up. Yumki. Next is Revolution, and you know, Revolution is always coming out with stuff, with a lot of stuff, but I saw this and I thought it was actually kind of nice. These are new highlighters from the I Heart Revolution line. You have three. You have a pure gold shimmer that is called Gold Star. You have Star Struck, which is pale pink with a white shift. Oh, that would be pretty. And Superstar, which is bronze copper. They're brand new baked highlighters. Let me see. They will retail for £6, €6.99 or $8 each at revolutionbeauty.com, which is their UK-based site, but they ship internationally. We have I Heart Revolution here in the store. We do not have the full collection, but we do have some stuff. So, but yeah, if I see them in store, and I will probably then swatch the pinky one. If I like it, maybe I will pick it up. I'm not sure yet. If the quality is the same as the highlighters that I have in that face palette that come in, you know, this very huge box, well, then I will definitely get one. Just so you know. So yeah. Okay, let's move on to NYX, if I can find it. Yes, here. NYX has recently come out with their Can't Stop, Won't Stop foundation, which they are also coming out with a concealer in that line. It says here, lightweight matte formula, full coverage with a finish that lasts for up to 24 hours. Let me see. You can use it to hide imperfection, brighten up your face and contour. It retails for $8.49 each, and it has 24 shades. It will be available November 23rd online at Ulta Beauty online and NYX Cosmetics online, and December 23rd in stores. I don't know if it will come directly to Europe then as well, but if it doesn't come instantaneously, that was the word I was looking for. It doesn't really take that long for NYX to release, well, what it has released in the US here in Europe as well. So I don't know. Let me know if you are interested. Let me know if you are picking it up. I am interested because I am still kind of looking for a concealer that does it all. I do have some concealers that I like, but they just don't give me the coverage that I want. And if I have a high coverage concealer like the Revolution Conceal and Define, that one dries out my under eyes. So yeah, I'm still in the market for a good concealer. If you have one, let me know down in the comment section. Moving on to CoverGirl is cruelty free. And I think that is fantastic. And I just hope that L'Oreal and Maybelline and Max Factor will follow suit. I'm really glad that CoverGirl is cruelty-free. We used to be able to get CoverGirl here in the Netherlands, but I don't think we can get it here anymore. At least not where I live. I do have Rimmel, L'Oreal, Max Factor, Maybelline, Revolution, and that is actually about it. Sometimes I can find Lotte London, not often though. NYC isn't sold, at least where I live, anymore. We used to be able to get it, but yeah. So I'm actually quite bummed that I cannot find CoverGirl here. I think I could get it online though. And looking at that picture, they have a colorful palette that I'm kind of liking. So yeah, I will see if I can get CoverGirl here, maybe from Beauty 88 or Boozy Shop, or you know, kind of a Dutch-based makeup site. I'm not sure yet, but if I can easily get them here, I will try some from them, because I'm kind of curious to see how their stuff is. I'm a bit rambly. I'm hungry. That's it. let's go to, well, ColourPop then, which is the last of the really drugstore brands. You may have seen it already, but ColourPop has done a collaboration with Bretman, and I have no idea who that is. I don't know. And to be quite blunt, I don't care either. I do like the collection. It kind of reminds me of the Mar and Sol palettes, but with less browns, to be honest. But I kind of like the collection. I kind of like the eyeshadow palettes. I also actually like the blushes. Now, ColourPop for me, I have to get from the US, because unfortunately, ColourPop is not sold here in Europe. At least not to my knowledge. I'm actually hoping that I put in a question at, I think it was Boozy Shop. I asked if they could check out if they could get ColourPop. I really wish ColourPop would be better accessible here in Europe. So if they would come to a European based site, that would be freaking awesome. I would really like that. For now, it doesn't interest me enough, to be honest. I do have prices here for you. The red, he has two parts in his collection, fire and water, and it isn't called fire and water, of course not. It is called lit and wet, just so you know. The lit collection contains an eyeshadow palette, which retails for $12. A super shock blush, which retails for $8. An ultra satin lip retails for $6.50. Ultra glossy lip retails for $6. Glitterly Obsessed Body Glitter, wow, retails for $8. Then you have the wet, is the same prices. No, yes, yes. So yeah, it is available already. It launched November the 9th. I am not really going to pick anything up, because for me to order from the US, from ColourPop, I need to be, well, I don't need to be, but I want to be underneath the threshold for import tax, which is 22 euros, which is about $25, something like that. And that excludes shipping. But yeah, it really needs to pique my interest, because including shipping, which is, I think, I don't know, $8 or $9 to get to me, it kind of makes the eyeshadows and stuff more expensive. So it really needs to pique my interest before I order from ColourPop now, anyway. So I'm going to pass over this collection, unless of course it comes to Europe soon, then maybe I will pick some stuff up. Let me know down in the comment section if you have anything from this collection, if you want to get anything from this collection, and all that goodness. Next is, well, indie. I don't really have a lot this week. Let's start with a European-based indie brand, and that is Lethal Cosmetics. They are based in Germany. They ship internationally. They are a little bit on the higher price range, for me at least. But they showed this, and I think it was 2 weeks ago. in Will I Buy It 11 then? Because this is 13, yeah. Then I showed a sneak peek of a few shades because I actually just found that brand. It is not a new brand, it is just new for me. But they released here all the shades to their Hive collection, 12 gorgeous new eyeshadows, and then you get a stunning magnetic palette. It is combined in one collection. You can also buy it separately, but from what I understand, if you buy it all in one, it is reduced pricing. Wow, it's difficult to talk. I'm really hungry. I need to eat. It is launching November the 23rd, along with great Black Friday deals and some more surprises. I have been hearing about Black Friday and I have no idea when it is exactly. But I am really, really interested in this one. I love the colors. Really love the colors. I have never tried anything from them. So if you have, let me know down in the comment section. And yeah, again, I am really interested in this. Now, I do have to pay shipping, of course, but because it is a neighbor country of us, I don't have import taxes. So that is good. So then I only have to worry about shipping. But this one, depending on the price, I do have to say that, is definitely on my wish list. Yeah, I think it's gorgeous. I think it's very, very, very pretty. Next is, and I have talked about this brand before, but I always mess up their name, I feel. It's Meeders Makeup Lab, I think, or maybe even Meeders, I don't know. They showed this, which is actually a sneak peek of something they are working on, which is their Krampusnacht holiday eyeshadow palette. Krampusnacht is how we say it in Dutch. Krampus is more of a Germanic feast. I don't want to make the video too long, so if you want to know what Krampusnacht is, Google it as well. Otherwise, the video will be very, very long. But I am really in. I just freaking love Krampus. But anyway, I'm really interested. Meeder Makeups or Meeder Makeups is based in the US, but I'm really interested in the color story. And the retail price, they are not too expensive, I thought, but I'm not really sure. But I am very interested. Again, I freaking love Krampus. Look it up. You will not be disappointed. Do I know when this will launch? Let me see. Keep the Hot Fire is a blush. Oh, so Keep the Fire Hot is a blush. Maybe Merry Krampus is then a highlight, or I don't know. I don't know, but it is very exciting. I cannot wait to see the full picture. Next up is this from Certify. I talked about this, the new palette that she was working on called the Affinity Palette a few weeks back. And she was still kind of working on the concept and deciding if it would be an all matte palette or that she would have shimmers. She decided on an all matte palette, and to be honest, I like that. I have the Destiny palette. I have a review with it. I have three looks with it. I will link it underneath the cards. And I wasn't really impressed with the shimmer formula that she had in that palette. And that is the only palette that I have from her. So I don't know how the shimmer formulas are in her previous palettes. But I'm actually glad that she went for an all matte palette. And I really like this color story. I am glad that she kept the lavendery shade in the corner here. I don't know when this will launch, if she will have a pre-sale, I don't know, or pre-order. She is based in the UK. Her website is is it Shopify? Yeah, and Blushstripe uses Shopify as well. And the nice thing about that is when you go on that site, it lists the pricing automatically in your currency. So that is very nice. So you don't have to calculate and stuff like that. But I am really interested. So this is going on the wish list. When I know when it will launch, I will let you know. Next up is, where are you? Here is a new brand, and it is called Feature Cosmetics. I have checked some things out. I don't really know a lot Only that they will be launching soon. I don't know where they are based. If they are US based or UK based, I'm almost guessing US based. And they are launching a few things. You see here on the top, you see an eyeshadow palette that they will be launching. You see some metallic liquid lipsticks. And they are also launching two highlighters. And I think they're also launching glitters. All that goodness. I will leave their Instagram handle down below so you can check out their Instagram page. I will also leave their website, their URL down below. But when I checked about 5 minutes ago, the website wasn't up yet. The eyeshadow palette looks interesting. I am going to pass, however, because I have all these shades. Granted, they are kind of spread out over different palettes, but I have these shades, so that is not really what I'm interested in. I do like the lippies because maybe it is a little bit controversial, but I like metallic liquid lipsticks. Not in every color. I do like it in the purple, the brew. I don't specifically need a golden one, but I do like the bottom three colors. I like dark metallic liquid lipsticks. I just like that. If you want to unfollow me now, I totally understand. But yeah, that is that's my confession. I like metallic liquid lipsticks, dark ones. Moving on. Wait, do I know when this will launch? Coming soon? No, I don't know when they will launch. If I know more, let me just do that and then follow them. So when I know more, you will know more. Okay. Next up is something that is way above my price range, but I wanted to mention it. I wanted to mention this. Melt Cosmetics is now at Beauty Bay. So that is really, really good for us Europeans. So if you live in Europe and you want to get something from Melt Cosmetics has launched on Beauty Bay. It kind of interests me, Melt, because they have some, I like the stacks, because I like that principle, but it is above my price range. I will check it out. Maybe they have, I don't know if Beauty Bay will participate in the Black Friday and Cyber Monday deals. Maybe they will. And maybe I will get something. Melt is on my brands I want to try in next year or the year after that, or oops, when I grow up someday, just so you know. The last one that I have is, no, it's not the last one, I'm lying, the second to last one. Ruby May Cosmetics, they showed this picture from their new Falling Star palette, which is releasing, which has released on their site. The reason that I didn't mention it last week is because I had already filmed it when I saw this picture. Just so you know. So I went on their site and it retails for 23 euros. And it was first, when I first went on the site, it listed it in dollars and I was scrolling through the sites to find this picture. And it jumped to euros. And then when I looked in the corner, they also use Shopify. So when you go on that on their site, it will automatically list it in your currency. I do have to say that the palette is currently on sale now. There are more palettes of theirs on sale. I do have to say that I am actually that dark, that bluish purple that is in there. I don't know if I feel that this that fits. It does give you more options, but that one and then the really orangey one are kind of, for me, like an eyesore, if that makes sense. I like the palette, but it could also be the lighting. I do like this palette. I don't think I'm going to get it, but because they are based in the USA and yeah, it is just a little bit above my import tax. And that is not really a problem, but yeah, the extra costs for me are at least 10 euros. So that would mean that if this palette is picked out of the line by customs, I would pay, $33 for this palette, and it just doesn't grab me enough to do that. So I'm going to pass. I did want to mention it though. Let me know if you have anything from Ruby May Cosmetics and if you like the quality and if it is something that I should definitely try and all that goodness. So yeah, so the last thing I want to mention, I'm not going to get, and I just found out that I cannot get, to be honest with you, but it is this Inglot and Wicked have collaborated. And I think that the collection is really, really fun. It looks really cute. I am drawn to the green side, of course. Of course. I think it's really fun. The only bad thing about it is it's US only. And I think that's a shame. I think this is, you know, everyone knows this musical. Everyone knows the movie. I have seen the new, which is, well, the Wicked movie, to say it like that. I have seen that movie. I love that. I freaking love that movie. So I don't understand why they just released this only in the USA and not just globally. I think that is a missed opportunity, Inglot. Not that you are watching me because you don't know I exist, but I do think that it is a missed opportunity. So that was what I wanted to end on. Or something like that. Yeah, this was the last thing that I wanted to mention today. Let me know if you want to get anything from this collection, the collaboration from Wicked and Inglot. And then let me know how it was. And show me pictures so I can be jealous and pout and all that kind of goodness. But yeah, this concludes my 13th Will I Buy It? New makeup releases, indie drugstore, going on the wish list, and all that goodness. So again, everything I mentioned today will be listed down in my description box. If I have room left, I will also list what I put on my face so that you know that. And let me know if you want me to do a full review on that big chocolate, this box. Why is there plastic on? Go away. On this box and the palettes that were in there. Because I can do that. Tomorrow I will upload my review of the Makeup Addiction Cosmetics palettes that I have. The day after that I will upload the three looks. Then we are on Thursday. Yeah. Friday will be my... probably my full face of Max and More products, or the unboxing and first impression of that huge chocolate heart box. Let me know which you prefer. So yeah, next week will be my review, full review and three looks with the Mia All Spring palette I got from AliExpress. This one, which is apparently a really good dupe for the Huda Beauty Electrical something eyeshadow bright palette. I don't know. So that will be up next week. And next week also a new Will I Buy It. And yeah, I have a few eyeshadow palettes coming. The Faro palette is on its way. I'm very excited for that. So of course I will do first impression, full review, three looks. That's goodness. I have two other palettes coming as well. So yeah, I have a full schedule. So if you want to see all that and want to know the looks I create with all those products and what my thoughts are, you just have to hit the subscribe button and then don't forget the bell so that you are notified of when I upload all those goodies and exciting things. I also want to do some palette bingos. I just want to do that because that has been too long that I have done a palette bingo. And I want to do some tag videos. Don't know when I will have time. I need to do my Q&A as well. So busy, busy, busy time for me. If you want to see that, well, you know what you have to do. For now, I am signing off. I wish you all a great, great day. And I hope to see you in my next one. Bye, guys.